Next on WoodSongs, the Wall Street Journal calls her the Queen of Bluegrass. A full hour with Rhonda Vincent and The Rage.
White smoke rolling, whistle blowing, listen to her engine in
Songs is presented in part by VisitLex.com, providing information and activities to visitors of historic Lexington, Kentucky. The Martin Guitar Company in Nazareth, Pennsylvania, making handcrafted acoustic guitars since 1833. The Deering Banjo Company, providing American-made banjos for front porch pickers and professionals online at DeeringBanjos.com. And by Fransky String Instruments of Prairie Village, Kansas, online at mfstrings.com.
Here on the Louisiana Hayride, his name is Hank Williams. The best in
town. On the Grand Ole Opry,
Bill Monroe and his Bluegrass Boys.
Hi, this is Bruce Hornsby.
Hi, this is Kevin Moore.
Hey, folks, this is Bela Fleck.
Hi, folks, this is Sam Bush.
Hello, this is Odetta.
This is Joan Baez, and you're listening to the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
And now, gather the family around and sit back in your easy chair. It's time again for the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour, our worldwide celebration of grassroots music. Let's welcome folk singer, author, and tree hugger, Michael Jonathan.
It was 1935, and a young opera composer named George Gershwin had an amazing idea. He wanted to compose an opera that featured African Americans. It was never really done before. And he produced his opera, and it was a complete failure. George Gershwin died 2 years later in 1937. So many decades later, in the 1970s, the Houston Opera Company discovered that brave opera featuring African Americans. And they performed it, and it became a big hit now. And now it's become one of the most important operas in all of North America. The opera is called Porgy and Bess, and this is one of the arias. It's called Summertime. You know it. Listen to this. Summertime, when the living is easy, all the fish are jumping and the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich and your mom is good looking. So hush, little baby, now don't you cry. You know what? Why don't you sing it with me, nice and loud? Ready? Summertime, when the living is easy, all the fish are jumping and the cotton is high. Your dad is rich and your mom is good looking. So hush, little baby, now you cry. You sound great. Well, one of these mornings you're gonna rise up singing, and then you'll spread your wings and learn to fly. But come that morning, nobody will harm you, 'cause daddy and mama are standing by. Summertime, ready? Summertime, when the living is easy, all the fish are jumping and the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich and your mom is good looking. So hush, little baby, now. pickle it a little. Just the audience, ready? Nice and loud. Summertime. Welcome, everybody, to the beautiful and historic Lyric Theater in our hometown of Lexington, Kentucky. We are broadcasting worldwide from Australia to Ireland, New Zealand to New York, Yuma, Arizona to the Yukon and northern Canada. Artists come from all over the world to be on our stage where we celebrate this magnificent world of independent grassroots music. This is like a multimedia front porch, and we're so glad that you could be here. You don't have to be famous to be on WoodSongs. You just have to be very, very good. And what do you do when you merge all of those things in one single artist, one single band? The Wall Street Journal proclaimed her the Queen of Bluegrass. She's one of the hardest working people in all of the bluegrass world, doing over 150 dates a year. She's the only artist to receive 7 consecutive Female Vocalist of the Year awards from the IBMA. She's also the IBMA Entertainer of the Year and a Grammy Award winner. She's got a wonderful album called All the Rage, and this is a tune off the album called Kentucky Borderline. Please welcome the incredible Rhonda Vincent and the Rage to the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
She pulled out a mobile in the pouring rain, moving through the darkness like a hurricane, from Southern Gulfport waters to the Cumberlands of green. Up lost time, heading for that bluegrass state of mind. White smoke rolling, whistle blowing, listen to her engine keeping time. Kentucky rolling, whistle blowing, listen to her engine keeping time. Kentucky borderline. We'll be right back.
raging locomotion, like thunder when it rolls, singing for the mighty who cast her molten steel, drove the spike and laid the rail drive beneath her wheels. The pride of our nation, she's a monument to them, a Southern Belle, mighty element. White smoke rolling, whistle blowing, listen to her in Jupiter time. Kentucky. Smoke rolling, whistle a blowing, listen to her in Jupiter time. Kentucky, borderline. Kentucky,
from a Grammy Award winning CD, All the Rage, Volume 1, Rhonda Vincent. It's so nice to have you here. It's like, I think your fourth time back, and we missed you.
Well, it's great to be back. Thanks for having us.
You have been working so hard, and you've gained a reputation of being one of the hardest working artists ever in the history of bluegrass, and you do work it hard, don't you?
We do. You know, we love it. A lot of people say, how do you keep up this pace, mm-hmm. and why do you do this? You know, why don't you slow down? But I love it so much, and it makes it easy when you love it.
And you come from a musical family. When you were a little kid, your family band. Tell me about your family band. You were like 5 or 6 years old when that started.
I grew up in a musical family. It's traced back 5 generations. I'm from a little tiny town in northern Missouri by the name of Greentop, Missouri. When I was 5, we had a television show, radio show, made our first recording. So I had this wonderful life of music, kind of on-the-job training pretty much. Started playing when I was 6. My dad got a snare drum.
Yeah, you were a percussionist.
I was. That's how I started out.
Ringo. You were Ringo in the band.
I never thought of it like that. That's right.
But it was... That percussion probably helped you with your mandolin player, because later, a few years later, you got your mandolin.
I did. And, you know, at the time, it was grandpa, mom, and dad, aunts, uncles, cousins, and friends. So it was the only instrument that was left at the time. Then we ended up joining a country music show in Marceline, Missouri. And the fellow there, his name was Buck Cody. And the proprietor, said, whoever doesn't play an instrument doesn't get paid. You know, I was singing on the show. So my dad said, here's the mandolin. Here's G, C, and D. Mm-hmm. And you'll be playing this. For 2.5 hours every Saturday night. So that's how I started playing mandolin. But yeah, it really did relate very, very well.
Thank goodness for those 3 chords, right?
Yes.
3 chords, you know, 1,000 songs. And now here you are fronting one of the most awarded bands in the history of bluegrass music with your mandolin.
With my mandolin, yes.
How wonderful that you won a Grammy Award for a beautiful album. Let's get into the second song. The name of the CD is All the Rage. This is a tune called Is the Grass Any Bluer on the Other Side? It's Rhonda Vincent and the Rage on the WoodSongs, Old Time Radio Hour.
Swung open wide. I'll bet the good Lord's got you playing somewhere up there every night. Is the grass any bluer on the other side? Guitars and the fiddles grind. The music ain't the same without.
you still? Is the grass any bluer on the other side? Did it look like old Kentucky when the gates swung open wide? I bet the good Lord's got you playing somewhere up there every night. Is the grass any bluer on the other side? The guitars and the fiddles cry. The music ain't the same without you, Bill. We miss you still. Is the grass any bluer on the other side? Did it look like old Kentucky when the gates swung open wide? I bet the good Lord's got you playing somewhere up there every night. Is the grass any bluer on the other side?
Is the CD, won a Grammy, all the rage is the CD. Rhonda Vincent and the Rage on our show for the entire hour. And Rhonda, I mean, certainly coming from a musical family, and it continues to be that way. Your husband, Herb, is very active with your career as well, helping manage and book things and stuff. So keeping things in the family, there's a lot of trust that comes with that, those kinds of arrangements, isn't there?
Well, and I think it's a peace of mind when you know you have your family working with you. You know, it's just a wonderful peace of mind that getting to work and to get to travel with Sally, my daughter.
Well, I think that's wonderful. We're going to discuss that as we go on, as we introduce the rest of your band. But right now, Aaron McDaris is your banjo player, and we're going to feature a song that's on this beautiful Grammy-winning album called All the Rage, and it's going to feature the banjo player, a song that he wrote, I believe it is. Is that
correct? Absolutely. He did write this.
All About the Banjo. What a unique title.
And you can relate to that, too.
Yes. Let's listen to it. Rhonda Vincent and the Rage on the WoodSongs, Old Time Radio.
Thank you.
Rhonda Vincent and the Rage for the entire hour. And Rhonda, what a band. I mean, the band is absolutely incredible.
So proud of you guys. I feel very blessed, and I'm very so thankful to have these incredible musicians to travel with.
Well, it's probably obviously very important to have daughters willing to marry good musicians.
I didn't see that coming. God did not prepare me for that. Sometimes it's not all it's cracked up to be. But you know what? That brings a whole separate set of challenges with it.
I bet it does.
And it's an ongoing, that's ongoing.
Yeah.
So
Tell me about rehearsing. You have a new song. You're thinking about the next album coming up. What is the Rhonda Vincent and the Rage rehearsal? How does the process go? Because when the audience is hearing you, it is so prepared and it's so dynamic and the musicianship is so pristine. When you're working it out, what goes on in the bus when you're working out the new song?
Well, I mean, we work so much that unless there's a new song, and we just got to experience that. This is just like having son-in-laws in the group, so many things that I could not even dream of. We were asked to do a song on the new Elton John, Bernie Taupin restoration, commemorating the 50 years of their musical collaboration. Mm-hmm. Never would have dreamed that. And what Bernie asked us to do is take a song that Elton did that they wrote called Please. And so now we weren't like I guess it's like taking any song. And we started thinking, how would it adapt to the bluegrass instruments? And I was afraid they would tell me to do it in a different, closer to Elton style. Mm-hmm. He said, I want you to make this into a bluegrass song. So that became the challenge. It's just taking the song and listening to it and adapting it. And that's the great thing. They're world-class musicians. And so they know their role. And so when we get that song and establish that, they all take their part in that.
Aside from your own personal career, you have worked with everyone from Dolly Parton, Alan Jackson, Tanya Tucker, Joe Diffie, so many others as a vocalist. So your voice is almost as needed in the world of music as you and the band in the world of bluegrass. And so that must really make your career fun because there's so many pieces to it.
I love that there's different collaborations like that. The song Where I Come From that Alan Jackson did, mm-hmm. Carrot Top uses that song in his show in Las Vegas. And so when I went to see him for the first time, they played that song. Well, I wrote him a note and I said, hey, I'm singing in your show. And we got to go meet him because of that. So see, it just opens doors all the way around. And we love Carrot Top. And Alan Jackson.
The two together is not, I'm not melding it too well.
Well, you have to go see his show. You'll see.
That's right. Well, let's get into the music because we got so much more to talk about, especially in the second half hour. But let's get into a song that you've got special for us. It's called Driving Nails. It is Rhonda Vincent and the Rage on the Wood Songs, Old Time Radio Hour.
So lonely, I've been so sad and so blue. I started out drinking for pastime, driving nails in my coffin over you. I'm just driving nails in my coffin. Every time I drink a bottle of booze, I'm just driving nails in my coffin, driving those nails over. Since the day that we parted, I've been so sad and so blue. I'm always thinking of you, love, and I just can't quit drinking that old booze. Thank you. nothing now I can lose. I'm just driving those nails in my coffin and worrying my darling over you. I'm just driving nails in my coffin every time I drink a bottle of booze. I'm just driving nails in my coffin, driving those nails over you. Yes, I'm driving those nails over you.
We are here for the entire hour with the most awarded band in the bluegrass world, IBMA Entertainer of the Year, Grammy Award winner, Rhonda Vincent and The Rage. We've got another half hour to go. Stay right where you are. Wait till you meet this week's WoodSongs kids. We'll be back right after this.
Hi, this is John McEwen, and you're listening to folk singer Michael Jonathan and the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
And thank you, John McEwen, founding member of Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. Creator of the famous Will the Circle Be Unbroken album. We are so glad everybody could be joining us here in our hometown of Lexington, Kentucky. We're coming to you from the crossroads of America's folk and bluegrass music, the gateway city to the magnificent Appalachian Mountains here at our home base at the Lyric Theater, over 537 radio stations worldwide. This time, on every single broadcast, we invite some kids from somewhere in North America to come visit us on our show, and they get to sing one song in the presence of seasoned touring artists, in this case, Grammy Award-winning Rhonda Vincent and The Rage. And from Clarksville, Tennessee, let's welcome the Borders Band, a family. Let's say hello to 13-year-old Emma. How you doing, Emma?
I'm great.
So you're here. You have Davis, who's 11, Daniel, who's 9, Ansley, who's 8 years old, right? And then the bass player in the band, Eloise, is 6 years old. She plays the bass. So how long have you guys been playing together?
Well, we started playing as the Borders Band about 1.5 years ago when Eloise turned 5.
It's the Borders Band from Clarksville, Tennessee. Simple Gifts and Will the Circle Be Unbroken, this week's WoodSongs Kids.
Gift to be simple, tis a gift to be free, tis a gift to come down where we are to be. And when we find ourselves in the place just right, we'll be in the valley of love and delight. Where the circle
Emma 13, Davis 11, Daniel 9, Ansley 8 years old, Eloise 6 years old playing bass, the Borders Band from Clarksville, Tennessee. You guys did great. Rhonda, I think it's a true statement that bluegrass music more than any other musical genre encourages kids and families and people to just get together and pick and sing kind of way you did when you were little.
I don't know of another music genre that will, there's a place for, no matter what level you are, that you get a chance to perform. And there's nothing like getting on stage, taking every opportunity to play, no matter where it is. Like, when we may have performed with my family, but when we were home, we went to the nursing home. We went to so many different places. And it prepares you for whatever experience that you're at, because you've played and you've, whatever can go wrong, it might have already done that. So when it does on stage, it doesn't faze you. So you guys were awesome. You're adorable. I love your boots. I want those.
I was gonna say, they match your dress.
I know, they do match my dress.
And the Borders Band is hoping to have the same kind of success that Rhonda Vincent and The Rage has. We're going to go into a brand new project of theirs called Live at the Ryman. This is a tune called The Grass That I'm Playing Is Really Blue. It's Rhonda Vincent and The Rage on the WoodSongs. Old Time Radio. Grass I'm Playing Is Really Blue. Great project, great song from her latest CD, Live at the Ryman. What a wonderful project, Rhonda.
Thank you. And it's with Bluegrass Legends, Mac Wiseman, Bobby Osborne, Sonny Osborne, and Jesse McReynolds. It's so special.
And the greatest legend of all is this lady named Rhonda Vincent,
oh,
I think.
Oh, bless
so.
Your heart. Thank you.
And I have to bring up this. The song that we just heard featured your daughter, Sally, and she's the sixth generation Vincent the road performing. And let's give it to Sally for carrying the torch.
That's right.
For a little while, let's talk about bluegrass music for a moment, because for a little while you did a foray in Nashville into the country, you know, the commercial country world, and you came back to bluegrass. It was like bluegrass was your true home, and you kind of landed on both feet, and you just really just tore up the road, and that was a sort of a return to your love, wasn't it?
It really was. I look at that as my musical college years. Now you can go to college, and you know, Brent he and Sally both have degrees in college, but Brent's is in bluegrass, old time, and country music from ETSU. And back then, I guess I learned from just going to Nashville, recording a couple of mainstream country albums, working with the best of the best. And I, you know, in doing that, you get out of college after about 5 years, two projects. I came to that crossroads and said, what am I going to do with my life? Because, you know, after you get out of college, what are you going to do? Where are you going to work? Right. And that's where I was. And I was like, what am I going to do now? And I just put together a group of friends, my first official bluegrass band, because I was with my family before that. And that's another thing. When you're working with family, that's a lot different than when you're working with other people. So it's a whole other learning experience and learning how to work with others, because when it's your family, they really can't quit usually. So then you're working with others, they can. And so that's just something to always keep in mind.
Right. Well, I think the bluegrass world is grateful that you came back.
So am I.
From the CD All the Rage, this is a Grammy Award winning track. It's Freeborn Man, Rhonda Vincent and the Rage.
Well, I was born down in the Southland. Twenty some odd years ago. For the first time, when I was only 4 years old, I'm a freeborn man. Lord, my home was on my back. But I know every inch of the highways and every foot of back road, every mile of railroad track. Another woman in San Antonio. Well, I always loved the girl next door, but any place is home. I'm a freeborn man. Lord, my home's on my back. Well, I know every inch of the highways and every foot of back road, every mile of railroad track. And a Kearney no-toe sack. Well, I hucked it about 200 times, but I've always got it back. I'm a freeborn man. Lord, my home's on my back. Well, I know every inch of the highways and every foot of back road, every mile of railroad track. Of the highways and every foot of back road, every mile of railroad track. 24 years old, I'm a freeborn man. Lord, my home's on my back, but I go every inch of the highway, from every foot of back road, every mile of railroad track.
Whoa. Josh Williams, Tony Rice Jr., doing it from Rhonda Vincent and the Rage. All the Rage is the name of the CD. Grammy Award winning album, Freeborn Man. I mean, Rhonda, the band is just amazing, and you have you've got a lot to be proud of.
Thank you. I loved that this project, it's our first Grammy. It features everyone in the group.
Just like we're doing tonight. You're so generous. You're showing everybody off. One thing I got to touch briefly, because I want to get all the songs in. So, you came through the ranks at a time when there was a lot of resistance to women in bluegrass music. Not that they weren't welcome and stuff. There just wasn't a whole lot of women, and you kind of became the role model. You paved the way, sort of the pioneer for other women in the world of bluegrass, and you've done it so elegantly. You've brought so much class to the world of bluegrass, and it's the way you perform and play, but presentation is everything. And the presentation of Rhonda Vincent and the Rage is always first class, and you deserve a thank you for that.
Oh, thank you.
You're like a pioneer. Let's get into the next song, because it's coming from your new CD, Live at the Ryman, When the Grass Grows Over Me. It's a George Jones song, Rhonda Vincent and the Rage.
And as long
when the grass grows over me. Yes, I'll be over you when you're standing.
Beautiful George Jones song. We got to thank Aaron McDarris on banjo, Mickey Harris on upright bass, Josh Williams, amazing guitar player, Sally Berry, Brent Burke, and this song was written by the fiddle player, Hunter Berry. It's called Wow Baby, Rhonda Vincent and the Rage. Before in the history of mankind, I think, do we need to come together? This world needs a front porch again. And this kind of music, bluegrass music, helps build that musical front porch from home to home, from family to family, from country to country, all over the world. And you know, it's something that Bill Monroe once said. He said, bluegrass music has brought more people together and made more friends than any other form of music there was. But I think John Lennon made the right kind of point. point. He says, you know, a dream that you dream alone, that's just a dream. But the dream you dream together, that becomes reality. We need a front porch around the world. That's reality. The dream of music and art and being together and community and what this kind of music builds, that is a reality that's within reach of everybody, including you, because you are performing at the greatest stage in all the world, your own living room couch in front of your own children. That's the way Rhonda Vincent grew up. That's hopefully how your family will too. My name is Michael Jonathan. I'm a folk singer. I am a song farmer. We'll see you next week on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour. Good night.
You've been listening to WoodSongs Broadcast number 939. My girl's opening song was Summertime from the Looking Glass album featuring AJ Daugherty on bass.
Well, there's our show. I hope you had a good time. We sure had a good time making it. If you'd like to send me an email, I'd love to hear from you. My email address is michael@woodsongs.com. If you visit our website, there's a huge archive page of hundreds of past shows. While you're there, you can find out how you can become a song farmer. And speaking of the archives, here's a scene from one of those past shows now. We'll see you again next week on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
I wanna be a cowboy sweetheart. I wanna learn to rope and to ride. I wanna ride through the plains and the desert. I west till the grave divide. I wanna hear the coyote sing as the sun sets in the west. I wanna be a cowboy sweetheart. That's a lie.
Closed captioning provided by Highbridge Springwater.
WoodSongs is presented in part by VisitLex.com, providing information and activities to visitors of historic Lexington, Kentucky. The Martin Guitar Company in Nazareth, Pennsylvania, making handcrafted acoustic guitars since 1833. The Deering Banjo Company, providing American-made banjos for front porch pickers and professionals online at DeeringBanjos.com. And by Fransky String Instruments of Prairie Village, Kansas, online at MFStrings.com.